What's going on? It's Nick here from Ways of Wealth. It's week 13 of the market recap. Feels like week 42. Quarantine, stay home, flatten the curve. You guys know what to do. We're going through all the highlights of what happened on the market this week. We're going to take a look at the stimulus bill that passed. We're going to take a look at what happened in the S&P this week, bear market, bull market, what market are we in? I don't know. If you know, let me know down in the comments. I'm confused. I'm going to give you what I think is going on, but obviously, as you know, my perception is not reality at this point. From there, we're going to take a look at some theories that I have of where we're going. It dead cat bounce. We've seen the market jump. We've seen it drop a little bit. It's a battle of the bears and the bulls. And then from there, we're going to take a look at our buddy over at Barstool, Dave Portnoy. No sports gambling for him. He's moved into options, and we'll talk a little bit about that. All right, let's get right into it. So we received word that the stimulus bill passed through on Friday. So that was some pretty good news. We didn't really see too much reflected in the stock market, but it was some pretty big news. It's the largest package that the stock market has ever received. Over $2 trillion. $2 trillion. I believe it's something like 10% of the GDP of America that they are pumping into the economy. So that is great news. There were some mumblings about how quickly some payments would go directly to people. There's still some questions in regards to that. Yes, some people are set up for, you know, they've been on unemployment before, so they have direct deposit. But there are some other cases where the login or the sign up process might take some time, so that might slow things down a bit. But they said probably about 2 to 3 weeks for those direct payments to come in. And I believe it's $1,200 for an adult. Married couples get up to $2,400 and $500 for every child. Now, there are some rules and regulations that are imposed here just based on how much you make salary-wise and so forth. So instead of explaining it, what I'll do is I'll throw a link in the description. From there, you can go and you can put in your own specific parameters, and it will tell you and calculate how much you are expected to get as a part of the stimulus package. There's other areas that it covered in terms of student loans. It's pushing back and suspending payments all the way to September the 30th. So that's great. You have unemployment boosts. So what I'm reading is an extra $600 a week for 4 months on top of what they already get, which varies from state to state, but it's anywhere between $200 to $550 a week. So you're seeing $600 added on top of that, which is great. They also want to extend the amount of time that you would receive that up to 13 weeks. So currently they range between 12 and 28 weeks. So that would be quite an extended amount of time, and very beneficial to the labor force, granted some of the unemployment numbers that came out this week, which are absolutely staggering. I believe it was an 1,100% increase. It's the largest percentage increase that America has ever seen. So it was imperative that both the Republicans and the Democrats work at coming down and getting this deal passed and getting this into market as soon as possible, ASAP. The stimulus package also included about $500 billion that will go to a lending program. This is for companies that support the economy and are looking for some type of bailout or handout. We've already seen rumblings this week because they want to put stipulations in. Stipulations in a sense that if the companies do receive the bailout money, they cannot pay out dividends for an extended period of time. They also cannot use that money to buy back shares, which then in turn inflates the stock price. So we saw this week, Dave Calhoun, which is the CEO of Boeing, who probably is not so much in need of public money. He's definitely come out and said that he can find alternative sources, but he does not approve of the restrictions that the US government is imposing. So that's something to keep an eye on, whether Boeing does go ahead with taking money from the government or finds alternative sources. And last but not least, the $117 billion that will go to our hospitals to ensure that we have enough materials to help us during these tough times. All right, next I'll throw up a 5-day chart of the S&P and we'll take a look at what happened. As you can see, it was an upward trajectory. We had officially bumped out of bear territory and we're heading technically into bull. It was the fastest growing week on the S&P since 2009. We were up somewhere along the lines of 20%. Things were looking strong. Friday was kind of dull. It basically was up a couple percent. And if we take a look just quickly, I will flip to the 1-day chart. And what you can see is the market was stagnant around midday, started to gain some pace, reaches peak just above 2600. And all of a sudden at 3:30, kind of that half an hour mark towards close, it plummeted, closing at about 2541, which is about 20% gain this week on the S&P. Now we'll take a look at basically where I think the market will go. What I'll do is I'll throw up a chart right now that highlights what happened to the Dow Jones during the Great Depression. And what you could see is this looks like it may be a dead cat bounce. Now, you may be asking what a dead cat bounce is. And a dead cat bounce, I love that, is a temporary recovery of asset prices from a prolonged decline or a bear market that is followed by continuation of a downtrend. It's small, short-lived recovery in the price of a declining security such as a stock. Frequently, downtrades are interrupted by brief periods of recovery or small rallies where prices temporarily rise. The name dead cat bounce is based on the notion that even a dead cat will bounce if it falls far and fast enough. So if we just take a look at the chart, what we can see is right after that 1929, you see the massive decline on the Dow, followed by brief spurts of the bull market taking over, followed by decline. What you can see over the next couple of years is that this trend is downward. So this is, in my opinion, where I think we might be going, just because unemployment numbers are unbelievably high. These numbers have never been seen before. We've seen earnings fall. You've seen a lot of companies pull back guidance. Like I mentioned in the last video, about 40% of earnings declined in 2008-2009, the Great Recession. You got to factor in that companies have completely closed down today. If we use that as our worst case, we're looking at 1,500 as the target. Hopefully we can find some type of cure or some type of hope that we don't get there. But that's what my inclination is. And unfortunately, I don't have better news. So it's something to keep an eye on. I think some great buying opportunities would happen under 2000. I think that's where we're heading. But don't quote me on that. That's just my own personal beliefs. Now on to some lighter news. This week, it was announced the WSB Championship was coming in October. What is that? It's a live streaming pay-per-view trading competition. It's going to take 12 participants. They're trading with their own money, and they're going to be trading to see who's got the most kahunas, who's going to have the most money at the end, or who's going to be left with any money at all. It's going to be brought to you by the Wall Street Bets, the guys who came up with the subreddit account. You know, just the way that things have gone with no sports. We've seen Barstool Sports, Prez, El Presidente. He's come on board. He's putting in options. You could follow his Twitter, talking to you about what he's investing in, what he likes. He was on Varney this week.
What are you buying? What are you trading?
So here's what I did, Stuart. I bought a ton of Lululemon, $3 million worth of Lululemon, and held it after the bell and got my shirt taken from me. So that's what I went a lot in yesterday. It didn't work out, but we're making a little comeback. This is better than gambling. I've been watching you all day for advice.
And basically, you can just see from his Twitter, he is looking forward to Monday at 9:30. I don't know if he knows about the pre-market that opens up. I think it opens up at like 6 p.m. Eastern. Hopefully somebody's told him. It's exciting to see that the younger generation that's not so well adept with investing will maybe get a taste. I know he plays the options and likes to consider it more along the lines of gambling, but it's definitely something that you should put some research and some hard work into. Well, thanks for tuning in and thanks for watching. I hope you have a great week on the markets. Happy trading. If this is your first time here, please hit the subscribe button. We'll be coming out with weekly videos. Smash the like button if you like it. If you have any comments, throw them down below. I appreciate all the feedback. Take care.